Hello everyone, welcome to the third session of Flask tutorial. In this tutorial you're going to learn how to add a calculator page in the API that we have been creating. So in the third session we're going to add this page, a page that can get the values from the user and do a calculation with four basic math operations, and then it will direct to this response page with the result. So before getting to that content, let's do a small review on what we have done in session 2. So in session 2 we created a response page. Like, instead of returning as message, we returned this web page through this render template. Okay, so render template is a package that we are importing. It is a built-in package that comes with Flask. So through that render template package, we created this index.html page, which will be directed by the Flask as a response to the browser. So that's what we have done in this view function. That's one change that we have done in the view function. And then in initpy we don't have any change, but here we created two pages. So one page is base.html, which is the basic structure which will get extended in all the pages that we are going to create. So instead of repeating all this basic construct with head and HTML tag, instead of repeating it, we are just creating a base structure which we can import to all pages just by using this extends. Okay, so here you can see we have used all this functionality, like for replacing the variable. So this one is possible because of the Django 2 package which comes with Flask. Okay, so that's what we have done in last session. Now we'll see how to add a page, one more page that we are going to add, and how we can integrate this functionality to the API. So let's get started. So first thing that we need to add is a page. So first we have to create a web page to display that calculator. So you can see we have this calculator page. So to display that, we have to create a web page. So let's add a web page to our template page. So here I'm just going to create a new file. So this file, I'm going to name it as calculator.html. So in this calculator.html, I'm going to extend the base file. We don't need to repeat all those head tag everything. So we are just extending the base file. And then we are just going to add the content. So first we have to add the content. For that, we're just adding this placeholder content. And then let's add in black. So whatever we are going to give inside this black content and black will be replaced, will be integrated with the base.html. Okay, so now let's add a div, a web page to display the calculator. So div class, and this one is going to display this calculator. This content will be displayed here. Okay. So now let's add a div to hold the form. Okay. So div, another div class. So this div is going to contain the form information. So we are just going to create a class called form. So inside that we are adding form tag to get the input. So here we are going to center this by adding text align center. So this one should be the internal. Text align center. Okay. So inside the form, the action attribute is going to have this the root view function that we are going to create. So we are going to create a function called math that we're going to integrate it with the root function. So root action is math, and it can be get or post. The method can be, it can be sent through get or post method. We're just giving post. And then here we are just creating a label operation. So where we have to give to some mathematical operation. So you can see here, we are going to use the select tag, select input to get the drop down value. So we are going to add that select tag to get the value. So the the idea is going to be operation that is getting integrated, like we are just giving the label for operation. So the ID should be the operation. So we have to add this code here, select ID operation and name operation here. We're going to add all the possible options. So the first option is going to be add. Okay, so we're just going to say addition. So like this, let's add all the other values. For subtraction, multiplication, division, and then let's close the select. Now we have to get two other inputs. To get the input value, we have to create two other form elements. So this one is to get the input, right? So let's add the input tag here. Input, it is going to be text input, and the name is going to be, so the first input is number one. And ID is going to be number one. So similarly, we have to get the second input. So the second, for the second input, we're getting another input tag. This one name is number two and ID is number two. So the third form element is calculate. So to have to submit. So for that, we are going to add a submit button. So for adding submit button, we have to use the input tag and type is submit, and the value on the top of the submit button, we want to display calculate. So we are done with the page. So we have created all the form elements that we need to create this calculator page. Now we have to create the response page. So to create the response page, for here when we add these values, when we submit, it redirects us to this response page. So now we have to create that response page. To create it, we have add a page here. In our template, we are going to add a new file and we are just going to name it as results.html. Okay, so as usual, we have to extend. So let's copy this content. We have to extend the base.html and black content in black. So everything should get extended. We are integrating the result page content here. So what we want here, we want to display the calculation results. So this should get displayed here. For that, we are creating a div and we are creating a class. Let's name it as header, and then we are going to say this is calculation result. So here we are going to replace the result content here. So for that, as usual, we are creating a variable folder, and this one result is going to, we are going to map it with the view function. So in the view function, we are going to create a variable result, and then we are mapping that result variable to this display. Okay, so we are just creating a folder here. So our result page, calculated page, is ready, and our result page is also ready. Now we have to add this, to get this request from the form, in our package we have to add two more packages. We have to import two more packages from the Flask. So we are going to import request package, and then we have to import JSONify package to get the values, the result. Okay, so that, for that we need JSONify package. So we are importing these two packages from the Flask. So that we have to add this content in our init.py. So our page is ready, and our package that we need to perform this operation, that package is ready. So the next step is we have to add a view function to map this operation, to map this application. We have to add a view function in our root page, root file. So here in our root page, we are just going to add a content to handle this new page that we have created. So for that, we have to use the decorator. So what's the decorator? @app.root. This is the decorator which is going to handle all the response pages. So what is the page that we have created? The page name is calculator. So this decorator will handle this calculator page. So then the methods, it can be get or post. So we have to add that. It could be either get or post. Okay, so both can be handled by this decorator. So the next thing is, so inside this, we have to add a view function, right? So here def index, like that, we have to add a view function. This view function is going to be calculator. Okay, so this is the view function that we are going to add. So here what we are going to do, we are going to render this page calculator.html. So we don't need any of these attributes, just we are going to render the calculator.html page. This is our view function. After rendering the page, this should do a calculation on the top of that. Not only rendering page, it also needs to do a calculation. So if you see in our calculator.html page, we have added this action slash math. So now we have to define what action needs to be done in our view function. So here we have to add another decorator for this root function, the math operation, separately. So we are adding another decorator to handle this operation. So the action, the math. So this we have to define here. So there we have, you can see the calculator, math operation, that we prefer post method. So that should be changed here. So we it is not get or post, it should be post, because that's what we have defined in the math operation in the form page. So here we have to add a function, view function. So this function is going to be math operation. So we have to define math operation here. So here we are adding this content. If the request.method is post, that means the method is post, if it is post, and if the operation is going to be, the operation, so for that it is the operation that we are going to select, and then the other two inputs, for the number, 1 and number 2. So number 1 and number 2 input. So if the request method is post and the operation and the number 1 and number 2 input. So for this request, we have imported the request and JSONify package in our init.py package. Now we have to add that package here as well. So from the Flask, we have to import request and JSONify. So if you add the request, this error will go. Okay. So when the request is method matches with the post method, if it is matches with the post method and the operation which is selected by the user, and the number 1, number 2 are the inputs. Okay. So there is space error, tab error. So if all these things, when it is post, then we have to select this in from all form, the operation will be selected and that will be saved in the variable operation. And number 1, which is selected by the user, that will be saved in number 1 variable. And then the second number will be saved in number 2 variable. Okay. Now we have to add all the operations. So you can see this ID operation. Now we are going to define this operation in this function. So now we have to say when the view, if the operation is going to be add, if the user selects add as the operation, then what we have to do. Operation. So the operation is add, then we have to get the values that we have saved in the variable number 1 and number 2, that will be saved in the variable or, and then we are just going to display this result here. Recall, we have created a, in the results we have created a variable holder result. So this variable holder and this variable should be same, this result should be the same. So whatever this variable result is going to have, that is going to get displayed here in this page. Okay, so you have to be you have to make sure that both variable has the same name. So this operation is for add. So similarly, we have to add the other operations for subtraction and multiplication and division. So I'm just adding an operation to do the subtraction. And then divisions, multiplication and division. So what we have done here, if the particular operation is selected, if the operation is selected, then do this calculation and the result should be saved in the result variable, that will get displayed here. Okay, so that's what we have coded here. So for each operation, we are going to do that particular operation and the result will be saved in the result variable. So now we have to render this template. So this whole view function should be written. So for that, like this, we have to add a, for this particular function math operation, we have to add render template. So this render template should render result.html page, result.html page. And this expects, this result.html expects this variable, right? So we have to specify that variable because the result.html expects that variable for this placeholder. So that should be passed here. So we have a variable result that is going to have this result that will be passed to this results page. Okay, so we are done with this view function for this math operation. So let's do a small review what we have done here. The root will direct this calculator.html page which has the math module, which this math module has a user defined function called math operation. This math operation use as a package to get this input. Since we use a form here, wherever we use form, wherever we get the input from the user, there we have to use this request package to get and process the user's input. Since we are getting the input here, we are using the request package, which we have already imported, which comes with the Flask. We have already imported it here. And then, for the input operation, and the number one and number two, we receive it from this form through this package request. Based on the operation, we have written the code to do the calculation, and we have saved the result in the variable result. Okay, so now all we have to do is we have to add this in here in the navigation. We have to add a way to direct this page, so we have to add this contact in our base.html. So in the base.html, we have only index page. Now we have to add this calculated page. So like how we have done for the home page, we are adding this calculated page. So URL for calculator. So we have added this in our base template. So now we have all the web pages that we need, we have all the packages that we need to run it, and also we have all the view functions to handle this operation. Now let's run this code. So make sure that you're in the environment and then run it. Let's click this. Okay, so I have clicked run the Flask app. I'm waiting for the development server to open the page. Take some time. So now you can see we have added this calculator page in our base.html. Okay, so I'm just clicking this calculator page, which will display our calculator page that we have created in the file calculator.html. Okay, so now I'm selecting the operation, and I'm selecting two values, and then when I click calculate, you can see it directs us to this result page, and it says calculation result is sum of 100 and 200 is 300. So let's see. In the result.html, we have given that variable result. So in the result, we have this content. So for the, if it is addition, sum of this number 1 and number 2 is number 3, that is 100 and 200 and 300. So calculator page, you can see whatever we have given in this calculator.html, that will get displayed here. Okay, so let's do a small review what we have done. We have created two pages, one for calculator and one for this result page, and then we have imported all the packages that we need, that is request and JSONify in the init file. And then in roots, we are adding two pages. One page is for calculator and one page is for this response page, that is math module. So we have defined two view function. Okay, so the first view function rendered the calculator page, and the second view function rendered the result page. So that is the end of this tutorial for creating a calculator app. So I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.